Y'all understand what we are to do, my brother?
Let's see, you got any questions?
Let's look at Deuteronomy chapter 28.
God hate evil. Why God hate a certain race?
How was y'all blessed? Hey, man, we out here for our people, man. We are the battle axes of the Most High.
A lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axes, y'all's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axes, y'all's weapons.
First off, giving our honor and praise to the Most High and the Son, Yahushua. Brother, you got that understanding? What are we, brother? We Israelite or we African?
That's right. All praise, brother.
Okay, so you know you're an Israelite, brother. I'm going to leave you with this. Give me Deuteronomy 10 and 12 right quick.
Bring it out.
Bring it out.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10, verse 12.
Bring it out.
And now Israel.
So now that you know you Israel, not just knowing that you Israel, going to get in and help you get there to the kingdom, but you got requirements. Because when we found out we was Israelites, we found out we had requirements, right? Read.
And now Israel, what does the Lord thy God require thee?
Read.
But to fear the Lord thy God.
Read.
To walk in all his ways.
Read.
To love him.
And to love him. We're going to go into all that. Read.
And to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul.
So first off, we got to show how to love our God, man.
That's right.
Let's go to 1 John right quick, man.
Bring it out.
Chapter 5, verse 13, man. Read.
This is the book of 1 John, chapter 5, verse 3. For this is the love of God.
But this is the love of God, read.
That we keep his commandments.
That we do what?
That we keep his commandments.
That we keep his commandments, man. That's the love that the Most High God is looking for in us,
right,
man. For us to keep his commandments, man. Brother, so
right,
one of God's commandments is the Sabbath day.
Right, teach
up. One of God's commandments is Sabbath day. Hey, is that a brother right there with
that's
that green
brother
on, man?
Brother.
Hey, brother, what you got going on, brother? Hey, young sisters and brother, did y'all know Christ is a so-called black man?
Bring it out, huh?
Bring it out.
Did y'all know that? Hey, brother, with the green scarf on, hey, brother, come over and deal with us, man. Brother, come over and deal with it. So I know a lot of time. Here we go. This was Sons of Thunder be talking about. Keep them sirens going every time the word come out.
That's right. That's everywhere.
That's all. It is. Everywhere the word come out, man. They bring them sirens out, man.
That's right.
They go down the road and cut the sirens out. You're like, dang, I thought y'all had something going on. No, they just trying to. That's what Satan do. Give me Mark chapter 4, man.
Bring it out.
That's what Satan do, man.
That's right.
Read.
This is the book of Mark, chapter 4, verse 14.
Yeah.
The sower sows the word.
Read.
And these are they by the wayside, where the word is sown.
So soon as the word is sown, read.
But when they have heard, Satan cometh to meet.
Satan come in.
Satan come to me.
That's just like brother right there with the green scarf on. Brothers is a distraction, man. You think we out here trying to talk to the brother, teach him the word of God, then brother come up here with some tights on like a woman, man. He got some women tights on with some UGG boots on. Brother, you know you need to shake that spirit on you, man.
Break it out, huh?
It makes no sense, man. Man on man is a genocide of our whole nation, man.
That's right.
Women on women is a genocide of a nation.
That's right.
And we let all the men start marrying other men, and let all the women start marrying other women, and nobody, no man and woman married, then we can kill the nation off, man.
That's
within
right.
Years, man.
Right. All right.
Hey, brother, do you believe in the Bible, brother? Brother with the green, do you believe in the Bible?
Look at that, huh?
Yeah, I know you don't want to hear it, man. You almost look like a door. Read it.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22, verse 5.
Uh-huh.
The woman should not wear that which pertaining unto a man.
He said a woman should not wear that which pertaining unto a man. Read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Read.
For all that do so.
For some.
For all that do so.
For justice will do.
For all that do so.
Not just for you, if you and anybody else that you know or anybody you don't know, they dressing a man dressing like a woman, except for all that do so, Reed.
Or an abomination unto the Lord thy God.
It's an abomination to our God, man.
All right, teach
out. A lot of times, people really don't want to hear none of those things, man. Reason why they don't want to hear, because they want to do what they want to do, man.
That's right.
Even Proverbs chapter 3 and 5, man.
Bring it out.
A lot of people want to do what they want to do, man. You mean, you give me Matthew 5:13. Read.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 5. Uh-huh. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart.
See, this is what our nation forgot to do, man. We forgot to trust our God, man. The Most High God put affliction on our nation. Now here we go, we want to trust in ourselves. Hey, bro, you believe in the Bible, brother? Brother. What do you say?
Stay straight.
Yeah, everybody say they straight. Bro, you believe in the Bible too, huh? You believe in the Bible? Hold on, what you got? Give me Ecclesiastes 7:5 right quick. Read.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding.
Because that's why you can walk by and say, I'm straight. Because you don't want to listen to the Bible, you rather lean to your own understanding. Read it out.
This is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7 and verse 5. It is better to hear the rebuke of the wise.
Read.
Therefore, a man to hear the sound of fools.
So you see what they got in their ears. They got them earbuds. They got all kind of speakers in their ears.
That's right.
They want to hear the sounds of fools, but they don't listen to the Bible. Right. Hey, young brothers, why y'all running from the Bible, man? Y'all walk all the way over there. Boy, them youngsters be running for the Bible, man. I'll tell you. Let's say Deacon Abigail said, scriptures come out and they running. They running, man. Read it up.
Verse 6, but as the crackling of thorns under a pipe, so is the laughter of the fool. This is also vanity.
Because all this stuff is vanity, man. When you're looking at this thing on the hindsight, see how the Most High God, how he deals with a nation of people, man. You think the Lord, he don't forget about us or something, man? A lot of times our people, they think the Lord forgot, man. You holding that, Matthew?
Yeah, I got you.
Reach it out.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 5 and verse 13.
Yeah.
Ye are the salt of the earth.
What the Bible say?
Ye are the salt of the earth.
Most High God said, we the salt of the earth, man.
That's right.
Hey, bro, you believe in the Bible? You say you good. Why you wearing a cross for, brother? You said what? Brother, I asked you why you wearing a cross. No, you ain't good. Ain't nothing good but one, bro.
That's right.
See, a lot of times brothers don't want us to say nothing, man, but we commanded to come out here and try to correct our people, thus said the Lord, man.
That's right.
Y'all thinking that we out here to try to pick on people because we ask y'all a question? Damn, when we can't ask you a question, but the police pull up on any one of us and ask you a question, if your ass don't answer, you get in that car.
That's right.
And then guess what? And if you don't want to go, guess what? He gonna call some more people down here and they gonna make you go.
Right.
And he's still going to ask you some more questions, and you still going to answer that question, man.
Yeah, right.
They be taking this thing for not like our God just a joke, man. We read the Bible, and then people don't, they so don't bear witness with this Bible, man.
That's right.
They really cast that behind them, man. Read.
Matthew 5:13 from the top.
Uh-huh.
Ye are the salt of the earth.
All right.
But if the salt have lost its savor.
Because guess what? If the salt lost its savor, we just thought they lost the savor. We saw lost our flavor, hey, bro. You want to get your green tea, ain't you?
That's right.
Half and half, honey.
That's right.
I know Dallas, what y'all call them? Uncle Melba, Honor Palmer, what y'all call them?
Read. Wherewith shall it be salted? And is this forth good for nothing?
Because guess what? We lost our flavor, man. Y'all think our flavor, guess where we get our flavor from now? The homosexuals. The homosexuals in when they go to rip the runway in Paris and France, whatever thing clothes they come out with, we're gonna wear it right over here.
Y'all know what the issue is.
What's the issue?
Let me tell you what the issue is.
Come on, tell us your view on the issue. Then we're gonna go to the Bible and see what
that's
the Bible
right.
said about
right.
the issue.
That's right.
My issue is that I respect everything you're doing, right? But you folks out here in the street, and I'm from the street, right?
All of us here.
That's right.
That's right.
But right now, everything that y'all saying and doing, it's not wrong that what y'all saying is the way it's coming about. It's not most St. Bernard from that. You know how they're looking
bring
at
it? It out, bring it out.
Y'all get through, are they still going to be hungry?
Watch
when y'all get through, are they still going to be
you
homeless?
You still speaking corny.
Are they still going to be homeless? What are you saying that's going to change anything in these people's life? They hungry right
okay.
now.
I'm asking something.
They in need right
yeah,
now.
You guess right? what, sis?
So what
you,
are we doing
okay.
to change that besides sitting here yelling
rhymes at the
they've already heard all of this. They've already heard.
No, they ain't heard. You ain't heard. You ain't heard. You see what you still ain't heard. What you doing? What you doing?
What are you doing?
This is what we doing.
What are
you doing? This is what I'm saying. Talk to 58 first word. Pray it out. Go. Give me Ezekiel 3:17, man. This is what I want.
Work it out.
See, the most high God gonna smite you, you gonna calm down, man. I can see that stuff coming on you, man. Read.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 17. Son of man.
What he call up?
Son of man.
Sons of God, man. Read.
I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
We are the watchmen out here, man.
That's right.
Read.
Therefore, hear the word at my mouth.
Say, do what?
Hear the word at my mouth.
See, because we out here to give y'all the word of the Lord, man. See, preach.
And give them.
And do what?
And give them.
Do what?
And give them. Warning from me.
That's what we out here on the block to do, man.
That's right.
We out here. We ain't got no soup kitchen out here to give y'all no damn food out here, man.
That's right.
We give y'all food today and tomorrow. You go right back doing the same old thing.
Right.
You ain't changed nothing.
That's right.
Just run your damn mouth, man. Stay with me, man. Stay with me. Read.
Verse 18. When I say unto the weak,
what he say, huh?
Thou shalt surely not.
Read.
And thou givest him not one, nor speak it to one the wicked from his wicked way.
Read.
That's right.
To save his life.
To do what, huh?
To save his life.
Read.
The same wicked man shall die in his iniquity.
Oh, this is the reason why, brothers, this is the reason why we got to stay in order out on the street. This is the reason why we must stay uniform, thus said the Lord.
That's
because
right.
What we are here to do is to save their life and to save our own damn life.
That's right.
This is what people fail to realize.
That's
we ain't just to save their life, we got to save our lives too.
That's right.
This is what the job is about, man.
That's right.
Now listen to some loud mouth woman thinking she can save the world because she's talking about we ain't feeding nobody. That's the white man's strategy.
That's right.
That's all that is,
bring
man.
Up,
you need to learn to trust in your God,
that's
man.
Right. That's right.
But his blood will I require thine hand. Yet, if thou warn the wicked, and he turn not from his wickedness.
So if we warn y'all, and y'all don't turn from y'all wickedness, read.
Not from his wicked way.
Read.
He shall die in his iniquity.
He said, that man's going to die in his iniquity. But watch out, watch this.
But thou has delivered thy soul.
But we're going to deliver our own soul. You think the Most High God is building us up, giving us all these laws, statutes, and commandments, giving us these precepts, helping us guide our household, helping us guide our children, and then we come out here and give this to the lost sheep? This is the food he wants us to give us, man. To give the sheep, man.
That's right.
This is the word he wants us to give them, man. He wants us to show them what eternal life look like. Don't tell them what a full belly look like. What's a damn full belly gonna get you, man?
That's right.
You still gonna be in sin, man.
That's right.
Wake up, Jacob.
If a man was homeless today, and we took him out the street, if he don't change his mind, he'll go right back to the streets, man.
That's right.
If a man was a drug addict, and if he did drugs, if he don't change his mind, you can take him away from the environment.
That's
but if he
right.
get right back in the same environment, he's going right back
that's
to the
right.
same
right.
man. That's why you can take a street nigga out of the streets and put him right back in the same streets, and he still will shine like a diamond because the Most High God put the law, statutes, and commandments in him, man.
That's right.
There's a difference between y'all and us, man.
That's right.
We got to show you what the Lord say, man.
That's
we ain't just to save y'all life. We got to save our own lives,
right.
man.
Read.
Again, when a righteous man don't turn from his righteousness and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him.
Guess what? He said he lay a stumbling block before him. Read.
He shall die.
He said, do what?
He shall die.
He said, do what?
He shall die.
Die, man.
That's right.
That's why we out here on the block We not playing no game. We fear the Lord enough. Guess what? We gonna tell y'all whether y'all hear from that.
That's right.
We gonna tell y'all this, man. I know some of y'all don't like it, but it is what it is, man.
Because that is not giving him warning.
So guess what? If we don't give you warning, we not finna. Guess what? You'll see brothers back on the block next week because brother ain't trying to die.
That's right.
Not in no sin. Read.
He shall die in his sins.
Uh-huh.
And his righteousness, which he had done, shall not be remembered.
So guess what? That's the reason why brothers is bold as a lion. That's the reason why brothers is, guess what, bringing dust at the Lord. Because we don't want none of our righteousness that the Lord gave us.
Yes.
The Lord said, he will remember none of our righteousness. No, Lord, we want you to remember our righteousness.
That's right.
Our praise to the Most High, man. Read.
But his blood will I require thine hands.
His blood, the Most High God, is going to require it at our hands, man.
Right.
Read. This is the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 2. Be not conformed to this world.
What the Bible say,
and be not conformed to this world. See, because she want to be like Jerry Lewis, man. She want to say the children, man.
Peace out.
Well, Whitney said she believed the children are our future, but the Bible said mistress women bring forth monsters, man.
That's right.
Guess what? I guess what Whitney was singing that she was high as a kite, man. Read.
But be transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Uh-huh, read.
That ye may prove what is good.
What is what?
What is good.
What is what?
What is good.
Because this is what we are here to do, man. To reprove what is good, man. Yeah, we believe the children are our future, but we ain't gonna believe these wicked ass children.
That's right.
We gonna raise these children up in righteousness, man. They ain't gonna, guess what? We gonna bring just as the Lord with this switch, man.
That's right.
Read.
That ye may prove what is good,
uh-huh,
and acceptable.
And what?
And acceptable.
Read.
And perfect will of God.
That's what we want, man. God's will, man. God's righteousness, man. Now let's go to Isaiah 58:1, man.
Bring it out,
now we got to show them what we out here on the block to do,
that's
man.
That's right.
We gotta let this thing ring, man. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 58, verse 1. Cry aloud.
What the Bible say?
Cry aloud.
Spare
not.
See, we ain't here to spare nobody's feelings. We ain't not out here to spare y'all feelings, man.
That's right.
Read.
Lift up that voice like a trumpet.
That's what the Bible commands us to do, man.
That's right.
We can't be playing a game, man. Read.
And shoot my people their transgression.
Show our people their transgression, man. Read.
In the house of Israel, Shalaka. In the house of Jacob, their sins.
In the house of Jacob, their sins, man. What you think y'all on the block doing? Y'all wants to come out here and sing Kumbaya. Y'all wants to come out on the block giving out cheese and biscuit salmon. Come out here, y'all want sausage and biscuit. That way Esau give y'all sausage and biscuit, pork
that's
ass
right.
pizza,
that's
pork
right.
ass pepperoni pizza, giving away food.
That's right.
And the Bible goes against that, bro. Hey, bro, what's your nationality, man?
Break it
out. So-called, you might be a so-called Issachar, man.
That's right. All right.
Yeah, man. You believe in the Bible? You know y'all a great nation, man.
That's right.
Guess what, man? Y'all build the Americas how it is to this day, man.
That's right.
Y'all been building in this country forever, brother, but they put a wall up around y'all.
Break
they
up.
Said that. They built this wall up. Give me Ezekiel chapter 14. They built a wall up around y'all, right?
Right.
Ezekiel chapter 13, man.
Drag it out, huh?
They built this wall up. They set this wall over here in America, right? Jump down to verse 10. Watch this.
Drag it out.
Watch this. Watch this, brother. Watch this. Watch what the Bible say. Read. They said they building a wall for y'all. This is y'all country, man.
Right.
This was y'all. The Most High God gave this land to y'all, man.
Right.
To y'all people, man.
Right.
We are the same. Guess what? We are the same brethren, man. Watch this.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 13, and verse 10.
Bring it out.
Because, even because they have seduced my people. Because
this is what they did to all us. They seduced us, man. Watch this.
Saying peace.
Uh-huh.
And there was no peace.
That's what they did when they came over here. They said peace to y'all, and it wasn't no peace.
That's right.
I know, brother, but the speaker gonna let you hear it, though. Watch. You're going to hear this word from behind you according to Isaiah 30 and 20, brother. Watch this read.
And there was no peace.
And there was no peace. They said peace to y'all nation of people, brother. And they ain't give y'all no peace, man.
Teach them up.
That's right.
Read.
And one built up a wall.
And they did what up?
And one built up a wall.
They built up a wall, man. Man, the Bible can't make none of this up, man.
That's right.
That's right. God, dang, I can't. This is literally in the Bible, man.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right.
Read it again.
And one built up a wall.
They said, and one built up a wall, man. Read.
And lo, others divided it with untempered mortar.
And they divided with that type of mortar. Damn. They put protection all around this thing. Damn. So they better destroy everything that come around. This is what they did. This ain't our people, man.
No!
Thinking on how this thing goes, man.
That's right.
Read.
Say unto them, which debug it with untempered mortar.
Say unto them that put the temple borders on there, right? Read.
That it shall fall.
It shall do what?
That it shall fall.
That's how God said Paul will fall, man.
That's right.
Lord, the Lord said they can build. The Lord said, I'm going to tear that thing down, man.
That's right.
Read.
There should be an overflowing shower, and ye a great hailstorm.
See, because that's what the Most High God going to bring. Nuclear thermal fire to this country, man.
That's right.
They building the wall for it to get burnt all the way down. Just like the rest of the building. All this thing got to come down,
that's
man.
Right.
All this thing got to come down to us at the Lord, man. Read.
And ye, of great hailstones, shall fall, and a stormy wind shall rend it.
See, because this is what the Most High God said. He going to bring destruction on this place, man.
That's right.
He ain't going to play the game. He gave this land to them, to the so-called Northern tribe. Then he ended up bringing us over here. Made us aliens in this land.
That's right.
Broke every covenant in this land.
That's right.
Then turned around here. So-called, guess what, Hispanics, they brought out the mariachi band in front of the dang old White House. Right. Now guess what Trump said, I'm going to build a wall. The Bible said, yeah, you're going to build a wall. Because I'm telling you, you got to build a wall. That's part of the prophecy.
That's right.
Part of the prophecy, man.
Read verse 12. Lo, when the wall is fallen, shall it be said unto you, where is the dividing wherewith ye have divided it?
He said, so when the wall is fallen, like, where y'all stuff at now? Where is that now?
That's right.
This is how God works. He's going to let you build it, man.
That's right.
You go and tear your ass down, man. That's why they don't build a tower at Babel.
That's right.
So you can tear that thing down, man.
That's right.
Read. Therefore, thus says the Lord God, I will even rend it with a stormy wind of my fury, and there shall be an overflowing shower in my anger.
So you're going to bring them nuclear and thermal fire to bring down shower and bring down hailstorm onto this place, man.
That's right.
But then they turn around and say that the so-called Hispanics is not our brothers. How in the hell they ain't our brothers? This is clear in the Bible. What's going to happen to our brothers, man?
Bring it out, huh?
This is a clear indicator. But you can't get around that, man.
Right.
You can't get around that, man.
That's right.
Seek your prophesied that thing in. Guess what? From that time and in for the future, man.
That's right.
Come on, man. This is a clear indicator on how Most High God said this thing's going to work, man. What you holding up? Breathe.
And great hailstones in my fury to consume it.
To consume that wall, man. This is how God work, man.
That's right.
He ain't no game with it. But guess what? Everybody got a job, like I say, everybody got a job to play in this, man.
Right.
And when we ain't on top of our game, the Most High God gonna come check our balance, bro.
Right.
He gonna come check our balance, man. He gonna make sure that we are in the right spirit, man. Hey, brother, with that head on over there, brother. With that vulture color head on. Hey, you know your nationality, brother? Yeah. I'll praise you, brother. You know it's requirements for that though, brother.
Bring it out.
Well, you need to be coming gather with your people, man.
That's right.
You need to come gather with your people. Come on and get this word, man. Hey, brother, you know you're using it while you're smoking, bro.
Bring it out.
Come on, y'all know what I want? You get through 1 Corinthians 12, 1 Corinthians 3 and 16, read.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10 and verse 12. And now Israel, what does the Lord thy God require of thee?
Read.
But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways, and to love him, and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul. To keep the commandments of the Lord. To keep the commandments of the Lord.
The Lord requires us to keep the commandments.
That's right.
Hey, brother, that's holding that fly, smoking with the blue shirt on. What's up, brother?
What's going on?
What's going on?
How's it growing?
You believe in the Bible, bro?
Of course, absolutely.
You do? And you do the things that's in the Bible. They say you're supposed to
do. You know why I try to live as holy and as righteous as I can, but in this motherfucking matrix and in this fucking system, it's hard, bro. I try. There's a lot of shit I didn't know when I was growing up. There's a lot of shit motherfuckers that they hide and keep from us.
That's true.
I grew up, my mom raised me. You know
your
what
mom,
I'm
a lot of people mom raised me.
Exactly. Motherfuckers trying to judge me.
I got you. No, we got you, bro. We listen. I'm just giving them a precept.
I'm just listening. I'm just smoking this cigarette with you, man.
I know. Why does the Bible say righteous, bro? 28:54. You got it?
Yeah, I got it, man. Follow me.
I hear you got it. I know exactly what it says. Read.
So that the man that is tender among you,
read.
Right.
You,
and very delicate,
his eye shall be evil toward his brother.
So, it said a man that was tender among us and very delicate, his eyes are evil towards his brother.
That's right.
That's going into a covenant spirit. Guess what? That's going into brothers just hating brothers for no reason.
That's right.
And also, guess what? That's also going into, we was loving and kind with each other, man.
That's right.
We used to care about each other.
That's right.
But watch this though, read.
And towards the wife of his bosom.
So guess what? He can't stand his woman. Why, brother? Why the man can't stand the woman? Because a lot of times women don't want to, she don't want to let stuff go. She want to run the household, man.
That's right.
Read.
And toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
So this is part of the curse. He said, a remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
That's right.
That's why a lot of women raise their children on their own, man. This is according to the Bible, man. This is part of the curse we're going to go through, man.
That's right.
A man's going to leave the children. Read.
Verse 55. So that he would not give to any of them of the flesh of his children.
So guess what? He, a man, leave a child in the heartbeat and they don't give his children nothing, man. Well, if this ain't how people work, bro.
That's right.
This is the Bible, man. Talk. This ain't our book, man. Read.
Whom he shall eat because he hath nothing left him in the siege.
Because they have besieged the city, man. And then guess what? The only thing we left, we had our children, man. Hey, brother, he just wanted to talk, bro. You didn't want to hear no Bible, man. Come on back over.
I've been here listening to you. What are you doing?
Yeah, I know.
I'm posted up right next to y'all.
I thought you were trying to run.
The way till I finish this cigarette and shit, I got to finish making some money and shit. I'm going to sleep in my motherfucking car tonight and shit.
You going to sleep in your car?
Huh? Yeah.
Where you from, bro? My bad,
please. Huh?
Where you from?
Man, my creator, my father,
where you from, man?
I mean, somewhere past the...
Read it, man.
The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16. Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
But the Bible said, man, but you know you the temple of God, bro.
Yeah, I do. That's why I try to take care of it, you know?
Well, how you going to take care of it?
That's
this
right,
smoke?
Man. Yeah. We all fall short.
But watch this though, bro. Read.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you. If any man defile the temple of God.
Said, if any man defile the temple of God, read, bro.
Him shall God destroy.
Say him what?
Him shall God destroy.
See, bro. You don't want the Most High God to destroy you. If you was homeless, brother, smoking should be the last thing.
That should be the money
you should be saving, bro.
Teach him up.
Should be smoking nothing. That's the last thing. That's why sometimes people get in trouble. They start go straight on crack and smoking weed.
What's the first thing I should do with my money then? Because I already paid my motherfucking bills.
Yeah.
I already just spent
all your bills. Why are you sleeping in your car?
Shit, because I got to pay for that bitch. What you mean?
So that's the bill you paying for?
Absolutely. They want me to pay $695 for that bitch. I took out a motherfucking...
So you... Bro, your priorities kind of messed up a little bit,
man. No, they're not. That's how I make my money.
That's how you make your money?
Yeah. I'll be doing
that. So, okay, I'm asking a question.
Yeah.
If that's how you make your money, that's fine.
Yeah.
But what's smoking going to do for you but take more of your money?
You know what? I've been trying to quit smoking for the longest time, and I want to quit smoking because at this point, like, I smoke, and then my mom be smoking now when I be smoking. And I just want to quit the habit and be a good role model and stuff for my family.
But guess what though, bro?
Yeah.
If I gave you $10 million a day to quit smoking, you'll leave them cigarettes alone today.
That's right.
I probably would.
Nah, ain't no problem. Ain't no problem.
That's the best way to quit smoking, get somebody some motherfucking money.
Guess what?
That's probably quit smoking.
The Most High God gave us a whole kingdom, brother.
That's right.
He gave us a whole kingdom, brother. Yeah. But you got to do what's required to get that kingdom.
And you know, I think the problem is, like, this matrix and this society that we live in, it just promotes fucking sin.
And
it takes away from the ideal of our eternal soul.
But guess where the sin come from, though?
Yeah.
You know what? Y'all just think about it. I'm glad y'all looking at them signs.
That's right.
Because we go to y'all, we go to their schools.
Yeah.
We go to their jobs.
That's right.
And only thing the first thing we see on TV is a white man.
That's right.
You know that's not the image of Christ, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
I believe it.
So why did y'all make sure people give us that image,
that's
though?
That's right. It's not his fault, though. It's not his fault.
Oh!
He was born in this
world.
Bring
it out!
He was born in this.
Can we prove that it's wrong?
Absolutely, it's wrong. The image.
I said, but can we prove in the Bible what you said was wrong?
That is not his fault.
It's his fault.
It's his fault?
Yes. Why do you think we the greatest nation on the planet? They can't beat us in nothing. But why do you think we're at the bottom, bro? Why?
Help!
We broke our God's law. So we paying for our forefathers. Watch this. Isaiah 14:21. Watch this. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 14:21.
Bring it out.
Prepare slaughter for his children, for the iniquity of their fathers.
See, because you got to pay for what your forefathers did. Let me ask you a question. Have y'all paid for that? Hey, brother, have they ever paid for this?
Hey, have I paid for this?
Have they paid for this?
No, absolutely.
They ain't never paid for that.
I have a serious question.
Okay.
I just said, I believe that Jesus is a white person. But y'all are still treating me as if I believe that Jesus is a white person.
Brother.
I never said that.
No. But he said that it's not your fault. But so we got to answer this question. You said that, but I'm just saying we got to answer this question too. So.
I agree with you. It's not his fault.
We agree with the Bible.
I'm not going to stand here and beat his ass because
we ain't going to beat his ass either unless he do something out of line.
I tell you this, there is going to come a time where motherfuckers going to reap the motherfucking seeds that they sow.
Boy, don't you know? Watch this.
This is the book of Revelations, chapter 13:9.
Bring it out.
Any man have an ear, let him hear.
If any man got an ear, let him hear, man. Everybody got some ears.
I gotta go make this.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
So, did this nation of people lead us in captivity or what?
My people led y'all.
That's right.
Does our God really want division?
Deuteronomy 32:7.
Bring it out.
Come on. Dude, you said the God wants division. Okay, we're going to see what God says.
That's right, just read right
it. We ain't saying, we're going to let God read. We're going to let God talk. Read.
Right. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32:7.
Right.
Remember the days of old.
Jump down verse 8.
Yeah. Verse 8. When the Most High divided the nation.
No, he put them together.
When the Most High divided the nation.
He has always divided the nations.
That's right.
That's what you're going to get with that war. War. Jeremiah 51:20. Battle axes, God's weapons of war. We don't battle axes, God's weapons of war.
We on the corner and we ready for war. And I know you ain't seen nothing like this before. We the battle axes, God's weapons of war. We the battle axes, God's weapons of war.